Hey, this is Pat Cox, and today we're going to be doing a Battle for Zendikar draft. And this is a pre-release draft, so in case you're wondering about some picks as far as cards coming late or why I'm still playing after I lose the first round or anything, that would be why. Okay, so just making sure I know what this does. Aligned Hedron Network does not seem very good. I mean, I guess if somehow your opponent has a bunch of Eldrazi in play, but not a super likely scenario. So as far as the uncommons, Chasm Guide is good in an ally-type deck, like red-white allies, though I don't love that archetype in general, so not something I really want to first pick. Spawning Bed, pretty good card, also not really on first pick. Windrider Patrol is pretty great. It's probably going to be picking, but let's see what the commons have for us. Not a lot, you know. No premium removal or anything. I have a natural aggression, which I like less than the typical fight cards, which usually pump the power and toughness at least a little bit to make you be able to trade up. Alright, well, I'm surprised that Ugin's Insight was passed, though you can see there's three uncommons left, so maybe there's a foil rare. This card is very good. You know, even if you have a relatively small guy in play, you know, scrying two and then drawing three, that's still great. So, yeah, that's almost certainly going to be the pick. You know, Breakover Army is pretty decent. Eight is a lot, though, so it's not necessarily going in every single deck. Undo Rising is a card I don't like that much. I mean, it's fine. It seems like other people like it more than me, at least people I've been drafting with in person. Retreat to Valakut. I've found to be a fairly powerful effect. I think it could even be a constructed playable card. But the problem is, like, in a dedicated landfall deck where you're potentially making more than one landfall, like, trigger a turn anyway, your guys are already becoming pretty hard to block if you're pumping them and they're already landfall guys. So I found it to be good, not great. But anyway, Ugin's Insight is, I think, the pick here. Alright, well, I've not had this guy yet, but he seems pretty great. I mean, just worst case, when he comes into play, our guys are indestructible, is a pretty strong effect. White-blue isn't necessarily a deck. I mean, you know, it's a skies kind of deck. It's like Windrider Patrol is good in it. You could potentially have, like, an ally sub-theme for ground guys. But in general, you know, you're not... You're either control or skies often with blue-white. So I think this is probably the card to take, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to... All of this is going to make my deck. I guess the other option would be to take the Skyrider Elf. You know, I don't really draft Converge. Maybe I should be, but probably end up two colors. So it'll just be a 2-2, which is still good. 2-2 flyer for two. Yeah, and then the only straight-up on-color card that is potentially worth anything is Rash of Ice. But that card's fine, but I'm not really excited about third picking it. All right, well, Coastal Discovery is pretty great. I mean, this is not Mole Drifter, but does a reasonable impression of it. What else we got? Well, this is an ally, so it goes with our other pick, but that's kind of all it does for us. You know, like black-white is kind of where you're gaining life and getting these incidental type effects. White-blue, much less so. You could have, like, the lifelink ally, I guess, or that card that we already passed that gives your guys lifelink till end of turn. But so I think, yeah, you know, we're seeing more blue than anything else, so it's basically Coastal Discovery or Clutch Currents, and I think Discovery is better. I guess if we knew exactly what direction we're going, like, I'd rather have Discovery in a control deck and Clutch in, like, you know, a Skies type tempo deck, but we don't even know that we're necessarily white, so. Alright, well, this is a pretty good quote-unquote blue card. But, you know, again, not something I'm looking to pick insanely high. So let's see. Probably the best card in the pack is Retreat to Emeria. You know, this, I think, is the most powerful of the retreats. For one thing, it makes allies, so you get ally triggers every turn, which, you know, goes with this and any other allies I pick up. But then also, it kind of... You know, you can switch gears at a certain point and start pumping your guys that you've already made with the card. So just given how, you know, it's a slow effect, but you play a lot of lands in this format, so I think it is the best card in this pack. Well, This card is pretty mediocre. You know, 4/5/7. I'm not even sure that it's better than, you know, just like random common Eldrazi. So I think it's right that it's still in the pack here, and I don't even think I'm actually going to take it. Yeah, probably the best card in the pack is Mist Intruder. Like, we don't really have any, I guess it's called processing, the uses for the ingesting yet, but I think it's reasonable to expect we'll get some, and even if we don't, I mean, this is a playable card without that. It's not very good without that, but assuming that you're going to be using the exiled cards, this is pretty great. Alright, well, I guess I'll take a second one. What does this do? Yeah, that's not helping me very much. Yeah, I mean, there's, like, some random allies here. You know, if we were trying to kind of go all in on our hero, then either the black or red ally would both be good, just because it triggers it, and reasonably powered or sized guys. This guy also goes in the same deck as I was saying before, like white, black, and life gain and incidental effects. Like that is a deck, and this is a pretty big payoff there. A 4/5 flyer for 5 is pretty nice at common, assuming you can, you know, give him flying a reasonable amount of the time. Well, Outnumber is the best card in the pack. I don't think I care about having this trick thing. You know, if I'm pretty sure I'm ending up in white, I actually do like Lithomancer's Focus a decent amount. I just don't know if I'm supposed to take Outnumber still being here as a signal, or if people just like it less than me. I think it's pretty good. You know, I guess the hero getting passed is a pretty is an indication white is open. Less so retreat. I guess I'll take Outnumber, but yeah. If I thought I had clearer signals, I would just go ahead and take the Lithomancer's Focus, which I think is a pretty good card. Yeah, I guess I can take Chasm Guide. I really don't like Brush of Ice all that much, so. Alright. So, Valakut Invoker is a fine card that I feel like doesn't really have a home. Like, decks are pretty synergistic in this format. You know, I could see this being good in my deck if I end up kind of more skies, just because, you know, I can attack with all my guys without flying. I don't think I'm going to miss either of the red cards, so I guess I'll take this. I can take Evolving Wilds in case I want to splash, or I can take Kozilek Sentinel. Like, I might still end up in red-blue, which Sentinel's pretty good in that deck. Like, there's a lot of colors cards. I don't think I'm going to play three colors, so it's just which my second color is, and this is actually a pretty good card if I end up in red, so I think I should take that. Yeah, Spell Shrivel is a card that I have not liked that much, but I haven't played it. I just don't like counters in draft all that much, but I've been told by teammates that it is good, so I should certainly at least give it a try. I might just be wrong there. Like, I guess people are probably playing more expensive cards in general in this format, so. Alright, well, for some reason the art is not loading on a lot of my cards, but you can see in the bottom right corner we're getting it. So, Deathstalker, I mean, we're not going to be black for sure. So, Cryptic Cruiser, you know, this is a payoff for that ingesting from the Mist Intruder. Do kind of have to be ingesting a lot for this card to be good, but is a good card if that's what you're in the market for. And then just lands at the bottom. Alright, well, you know, we could take Tightening Coils, you know, if we think we're going to end up being a Skies-type deck, but I really don't know what we're going to be right now, so probably best just take the best card. I mean, you know, the bottom end of this is it's a Hill Giant, which is just a playable, reasonable card. So this guy is just pretty great just in any deck. Like, I've yet to return him, but just 6/6 Vigilance for 6. Like, the Uncommon Spider in M15... that also had reach, but it was Vigilance 6/6, was great, and the reach didn't even matter that much. It was mostly just that it was this giant thing on attacking and on defense. So I think that's probably going to be the pick, but let's look at the rest of the pack. You know, Grove Rumbler didn't do anything for us. Yeah, a bunch of green cards. Another Spell Shrivel. Merc Strider, which is a fine card, but we don't really have enough ingesting it to guarantee that we're going to be able to use it. So I'd rather just take the... I think this card's better than it anyway. Alright, well, a second copy of Coastal Discovery. That's pretty nice. It's probably an... Probably you can have too many of that, I would guess, and two might even be it. I don't like if a third came, I don't think I would take it, and if there was like a good card for my deck here, I might not take it, but got a bunch of green stuff, an Eldrazi Devastator that I don't really care about, and some like playable but not exciting blue cards that are not Coastal Discovery, so I'll just take Coastal Discovery. Alright, well, Envoy doesn't really go in our deck. The drone is fine in our deck. I don't really like this card all that much, but it's fine. You know, it's kind of, are we playing white or blue, or sorry, red or blue, pardon me, we're playing red or white, because Fortified Rampart does fit in our deck if we're just trying to kind of turtle up and cast a bunch of Coastal Discoveries. You know, Chasm Guy doesn't fit in that type of deck. Though nor does Undo Rising, so, you know, a lot of my non-blue cards don't really fit that well with turtling up anyway. But I have, like, kind of a lot of fours already, and Incubator Drone's pretty mediocre. I'm going to take the Rampart. Alright, which one is this? Alright, yeah, this card's pretty great. Yeah, I mean, just, like, cast Coastal Discovery, then get this back. That is some high value right there. yeah, Clutch of Currents is pretty good. I don't actually know which of these is better, but I already have multiple Awaken cards. If I'm just casting this for blue, I mean, that might help keep me alive. Maybe I need to do that sometimes, but probably not really looking to do that. Probably looking to just get value. Alright. Well, Salvage Drone does technically ingest, but is incredibly bad at it, so don't think we're looking for that card. Stonewalker is a fine card. I've not been super impressed with it. I don't think it is really an indication like, oh, I should be red. Nettle Drone is actually very great. It is sort of an indication I should be red. But, yeah, I'm still not sure that it... Maybe I should just be... White-blue definitely... You know, this wall will allow me to play the type of game I'm playing better than a Nettle Drone will. So, yeah, I guess I'm going to take the wall. Well, there's only one card on color. It's not something I'm super excited about, but it's fine. It's a 3-power flyer. Okay. So again, we don't really have a lot of ingest, in which case this guy is not very good. We also have a lot of fives already, so we could take Valka Invoker, though I think we're reasonably sure we're in blue, but we might not, or sorry, in white, but we might not be. I don't even really want the Invoker, or sorry, the Oracle. I don't really want the Invoker either, but I have no threes. I guess I'll take this. Might as well, like, stay semi-open in case we open some awesome red card. Titan and Coils will probably make our deck. Alright, yeah, I'll take a Rune Processor. It's a finisher. Well, this has become a deck where Lithomancer's focus is not very good. I mean, it's a playable card, but I'm not really tangling in combat too much, I don't think. Let's take this. Could see Blighted Step being okay in my deck. I mean, both are fine. Like, I don't know that I'm aggressive enough for Stan Simbridge to actually be good, so maybe I want this. Stand Stone Step, I don't really know what it's called. But the white tap lands. Now the green tap land I think is pretty good. It's kind of surprising that it's last pick here. All Well, we got both Brood Butcher and Catacomb Sifter. So, two, you know, cards that go in a in deck we're not going to be playing. So, take Felidar Cub, which is pretty crappy. Or you take the red guys, which are either of them are pretty good. It's like my red and white are pretty equally mediocre. I didn't even notice we had this sheer drop in here. Never mind. All right, yeah, we'll take the sheer drop. Like, I think if it was pick one, I might take Vial Aggregate over sheer drop, but not at this point. I just want to draw some cards close to discovery. Eventually win with my six or seven drop Eldrazi. Of course, no sooner do I say that than I get a dragon. Alright. Could also take a Sky Spawner. Corn Tangler's not very good in our deck. This card is... What happened to my preview? Anyway, this card is fine. It's not like, oh my god, I need this. Man. Really hate waffling back and forth like this. Like, I could just take the Sky Spawner, but like... This dragon's pretty good. It's not insane or anything, but it's good. Don't really have a lot of reason to be in white versus red. Alright, well, I'm not going to take this stupid thing. Yeah, I don't want Allie's invitational card. Turn Against is a card that, like, that kind of effect is usually pretty sweet, and I thought it would be great, but... I mean, it's fine. I don't think my deck necessarily cares about it. I guess Outnumber's also not, like, totally insane in my deck or anything, but it's fine. Like, a little low on creatures, but not so low that it can't still be a shock or whatever. Yeah, we'll just take Outnumber. Well, I think we just want another Sentinel. I mean, these are close enough to Fortified Ramparts for what we want the Fortified Ramparts for. And another Sheer Drop. Well, if we find a way to splash, we find a way to splash. Play the first Sheer Drop. If we don't, not a big deal. Well, pretty low on threes, and Eldrone's pretty good. I've already passed several of them. I do think, like, pick one, I would take Firemantle Mage over it, because you don't really need to be in allies for this card to be good. Just having the effect, like, one time is good enough. It's a lot like, I think it's Seismic Elemental from M15. Sorry, Magic Origins. I don't know if I said M15 earlier, but whatever the last core set was. With, anyway, where 4-4 for 5, reasonable card, and the effect just sometimes wins the game immediately. 2-2 for 3 is less reasonable than 4-4-5, but it's still, like, a fine card, and the effect is very powerful if you draw it as a spell later. But, yeah, I think I'll take Nettle Drone. I have a lot of stuff to do on 4 already. Stone Fury. Yeah. I'll certainly take a Stone Fury. Yeah, nothing else here, right? Okay. Like, take another Wind Rider Patrol. I already have kind of enough power in that department. Let's see how many cards I actually have. So I have plenty of cards. I don't need to, like, I could take Evolving Wild to splash, but I don't think I need to be splashing. Like, I think I just don't need the Sheer Drop. So really the question is, would I rather have another Patrol, which is just a very good card, or... I mean, it's definitely better than this recruit. Like, I would gladly cut that card. Or would I rather have another Sentinel, which does an early drop? I'll take the Patrol. I don't know. Like, it seems like enough early drops, and I'm not really, like, a Sentinel deck, per se, where, like, I'm going aggressive and it's awesome in my deck. Just cut this thing. I guess Chasm Guide's also not making my deck. Yeah, that pick I'm not sure of. Might have been wrong, especially since I have outnumbers and I'm trying to get stuff early on the board to actually use the outnumbers. All right, well, I guess Tightening Coils. I could just take this because it's an awesome card and I want to play against it. But... All right, let's see here. Only have... I guess Spell Shrivel counts. So I have three ways to exile stuff. Is that enough to play Merc Strider? My guess would be no. Yeah, whatever. Walls just seem very good in my deck. Sky Spawner. Guess Dispel is a reasonable sideboard card. Well, I don't even really like this card that much, so I guess I'm going to take Manta, but I don't know that Manta's even going to make my deck. Seems like not very likely it will. Well, I got one of them, I have no idea. I might need this for Constructed, so that's pretty good. Save myself 10 cents. Alright, so let's lay out the deck. I'll pause here for a second. Okay, well, I like Ruin Processor fine. I probably have enough finishers already with my 2/6s and 2 Coastal Discoveries and such that I don't really need to play it. So I think I can just cut this. I'm also not really guaranteed to gain the 5 life. Not that you can't play it without that, but... I don't particularly love Spell Shrivel or Tightening Coils. You know, they're fine cards, but I do feel like I'm probably going to be tapping out a pretty decent amount in this deck with 2 Coastal Discoveries and such. Like, I don't really have a lot of instants, you know. I might make Tightening Coils a little bit better, at least. I guess, you know, Cruiser is still okay. Like, I guess it, you know, triggers Nettle Drone, it triggers Kozilek Sentinels, and then with Mist Intruder, I will be able to exile things some amount of the time. You know, I guess that is another... Is Mist Intruder really worth it? I didn't get a lot of payoff for exiling things, really. I mean, it's basically just this, so... Is it even worth playing the Intruders? Yeah, I don't know. Probably isn't. I mean... Do I really care that much about a 1/2 flyer? Feels weird to cut that card, but I think that might be right. Then I only got Bladed Step as utility land, so... Alright... Yeah, feels very weird to cut that card, but Mist Intruder, but... Though I guess if I'm cutting that, I can't really play Cruiser, that doesn't make any sense. I mean, I can, just as a Hill Giant, it's not super exciting. I do think Tightening Coils are probably pretty good in my deck, because I have, like, a bunch of flyers that I hope to win the game with. I can see, like, Rush of Ice, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. I guess I could also see, like, Spell Shrivel over Cryptic Cruiser, because it doesn't do anything in our deck. Or playing, like, Shatter Skull Recruit or something over it. I mean, maybe that's better. Yeah, I guess 3/3 for 4 is not... That's probably fine. Like, the counterspell is still going to be good a little bit later in the game. Like, I'm drawing a million cards. I will be hitting all my land drops. All right. I will see you guys for round one.